Okay, so welcome everybody, Axel Fireflurry here, to a new segment I like to call Trainer Chat, and we have the awesomely intelligent, super talented, amazingly awesome, Jennah. Oh, this is going to happen every time, just so you know.
Oh, no.
Praise every time.
Yeah, we had to do a second shoot because people are annoying.
So, oh, do I know that? I actually have an angry letter on my door saying, no one come. No knocks, no nothing.
I was about to say, that first line, giggity? Or no giggity? Eyebrow quirk? No? Okay.
Eyebrow quirk.
Okay. Okay. So, subject was...
What makes a competitive player, like, is there really such a thing as a competitive and a casual player?
I say yes. And basically, what I think what makes someone a competitive player is if they have an interest in the meta and they have gone out of their way to try and further themselves in knowledge of the meta. And they've also, you know, they also have to at least have one battle under their belt. They have that one requirement.
I could see how the one battle would work. I myself would not feel like I'd be a competitive player until, you know, like I did get the knowledge of, like, what kind of a role that a Pokemon would play and actually understand it. And at least maybe, like, four, maybe five battles under my belt, because I don't think you can get enough of an idea through just one battle.
Yeah, especially if you win, because ironically enough, winning doesn't give you the knowledge that losing does.
Now, see, I completely agree to that, because I did sports in high school, I do martial arts now, and I never feel as good when I win as when I lost. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm on cloud freaking nine when I win. But cloud nine and a half is where I like to be, because I'm like, okay, this is... Okay, what did I do wrong? What can I do to better this situation so I don't... get spanked like a newborn baby next time.
But there's, where this argument becomes interesting is when people argue about certain things, like if you breed and train your own Pokemon, and they say that if you use PokeGen, PokeEdit, PokeSave, PowerSave, and what was the new thing from Japan? Yeah, there's this thing in Japan where you can edit a Pokemon just so it can be in its mega form at its base, and then you can give it another item. So,
what?
Essentially, you could make a Charizard Y and then let it hold Charizard X. So now you have a Charizard X boosted in the sun.
Oh my goodness, that's a whole lot of evil.
Yeah.
Now, I know the Power Saves just came out with, like, the nature modifier.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was actually expecting Ramos to have a video about that.
Ramos is in a sticky situation where he likes Power Save mainly to edit the bulls and make certain Pokemon shiny, because he thinks some of them look better in their shiny form than they do in their base form.
I will
agree. But everyone makes him out to be, like, this anti-Power Save angelic god, that he is completely against it and that it should be burned at the stake. But that's not really the case. He doesn't like it for, like, making the Pokemon itself. He just likes it for, like, editing, like, small aesthetic details.
Yeah, like how I put my Meloetta in a love ball, because I love Meloetta.
Oh my god.
I promise I'm not a Pokephile, I promise.
Uh-huh. Sure.
I promise.
And speaking on the context of balls, you already said that you knew a little bit about this, but when, what is it, the three-time U.S. Nationals champion, I think he's the three-time U.S. Nationals champion, not the world, he might be the world champion, I forget. All I know is that I've heard this name a lot of times whenever I do competitive play, even back before I really got into it. Like, I used to watch the U.S. Nationals and the World streams, even before I was playing competitive. And I heard Ray Rizzo's name thrown around a lot. And this year, he got himself in a little bit of a pickle. Not only because he had an illegal Aegis Slash, which was in a Dream Ball, which, if anyone needs any explanation for that, a Dream Ball is only obtainable in Gen 5. Balls only passed down from females, so you cannot legally get an Aegis Slash in a Dream Ball. You also can't get any Pokemon in an Apricorn Ball with its hidden ability, because Apricorn Balls can only be passed down from females, and they can only be obtainable in Gen 4. And as of Gen 4, hidden abilities were not released yet. And the only way you could pass down a hidden ability and the ball is if the female was in that ball with that hidden ability. So, he had a Politoed in a Lure Ball, and I think he had a Ludicolo that was... Oh, no, the Ludicolo was fine. But it was the Politoed in a Lure Ball that was illegal as well. People just kind of dropped off in caring about that, though, because they hadn't realized that until, like, a month later after the whole Aegis Slash thing. And everyone was just kind of burnt out on the subject. But point being, his story was that his friend had traded him the Aegis Slash and the Politoed breeding pairs, and that he bred the rest of it himself so that it would be in his OT and he could nickname it and whatnot. But I call bullshit on that, because you don't realize that not one but two of your Pokemon are in illegal balls and then just kind of drop off on that. Like, I do this kind of research, and I'm not even like... Like, I am competitive, but I'm still learning. But even I know these things. Because I don't want to get in trouble when I go to a U.S. Nationals or a Worlds or even just a Regionals. I don't want to get in trouble for that kind of shit. So I fine-comb through all my Pokemon to make sure everything's fine.
Oh, definitely. That's completely understandable. Now... Another weird, interesting subject about competitive play. What do you think about the Smogon Uber tier? What's your thoughts and opinions on that?
I like the idea that certain things are banned from, like, the regular meta, because Ubers is essentially a ban list. The thing I don't like is that some of the Pokemon in there weren't given really a fair chance when they were suspect tested. Like,
definitely.
Like Mega Maywall and Aegis Slash and some of the newer Megas. Even, I'm pretty sure Charizard X is being suspect tested right now, because the whole reason why Charizard Y isn't suspect tested is because of Stealth Rocks.
Yeah, Stealth Rocks bring that thing down to like half, and it's just an...
Yeah, it's free.
Yeah. I mean, I can agree. I can understand why some things are in the Uber tier, like, okay, now I absolutely hate having to bring this particular YouTuber up, because I feel like you know who I'm talking about.
I think I do.
You know who I'm talking about.
I think I do.
Yeah, but see, here's the sad thing, like, he used, I will not doubt, okay, he even admits that they were hack-gen Pokemon, but... Okay. Like the two times that he actually ended up beating me, it was because they were quick throw together teams, because he had told me and whatnot that, oh, these are just quick throw together teams and all this hoo-ha. And I actually have a battle video with him, and I actually have my Darkrai on my team. And even then, I obeyed the sleep clause, because, I mean, I hated using Darkrai, because I'm like, he is an Uber, he may be one of my favorite legends, but I felt like it was unfair, because I could have just swept his entire team just with Darkrai, and just bad news bears for him, but I still think I beat him in that video. Who knows? Don't care. But, I mean, I'll follow Sleep Claws if I just throw a Darkrai in my team for kicks and giggles, because I'm weird like that. I don't fill up my battle box in my normal walk-around party, so if somebody challenges me to a battle, I'd like to make sure that I have a team ready. Which is why I should just fill up my battle box so when I'm breeding, I'm not stuck with a Tatanflame and 12 eggs. Every time, middle of breeding, let's have a battle.
No, see, like, I stopped accepting random battles specifically from Japanese players, and I know that's probably going to sound racist, but that editing tool that I told you about that was specifically released in Japan that lets you mod, like, so you have a mega holding a mega stone of another mega, yeah, no. See, that's why. I was just like, I don't want to deal with it.
Yeah, I actually had a really interesting battle. It was a triple battle at the time, and he had, if I remember correctly, all legends. And I ended up completely beating him down with a team that one of my friends had sent me. And I think that's a really interesting concept, because everyone has this strange idea that all legendary Pokemon are these ultimate godly beings.
Well, technically, by game lore, they are, but as far as competitive goes, there are some that are down in, like, the really low tiers, like UU, and I think there's one in, I don't want to say PU, but there's a tier above that.
NU?
Yeah, I think that was it. But it was, shit, what is it, Curium Black was in, like, a really low tier? I know that much. Because it had, like, a really poor typing.
Yeah, because it's a dragon and ice.
Mm-hmm. So it's like, glass cannon!
He's actually on my current Blizzard team.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I mean, I'm still working out the kinks on it, but I'm like, you know what? Let's make a weather team. Because I did the sand team. And sun teams are used way too often. Sand teams are kind of common, at least from what I've experienced. So I'm like, you know what? Let's make it snow. Blizzards all around.
The only thing I could come up with that is like having Mamoswine and a bomb of snow, but I couldn't figure out anything else besides that, and I was just like, eh, I'm lazy.
Abominus Snow's actually not in my team.
Really?
No, Abominus Snow is. It's Mamoswine who's not on my team.
Ah.
Yeah, I can't even remember exactly who's in it, which is sad because my 2DS is like 2 inches away from me.
Mine's actually right here.
But yeah, I know I have a Mega Abominus Snow, Kyurem Black, I believe a Starmie, and oh my gosh, I can't remember who the others were, but that's completely fine and dandy. I can live with that. But, now, what would you consider to be a scrub player? Because I hear that term get thrown around like candy at the 4th of July.
Okay, what I believe is a scrub player is actually pretty much what Ramos said, plus a little something else. I believe someone is a scrub player if, when they're presented with facts, like let's look back at the you know, who we were talking about earlier.
He who should not be named.
He who shall not be named. When we try to tell him that his Pokemon are genned and hacked clones and whatnot, if you don't know what the Pokemon you're using are clones, you are a scrub. Okay? No argument about it.
Oh my goodness, I can't remember what I said, but he was talking about Sharpedo, and I think he said Sharpedo was a special attacker?
Yeah, I have that on screenshot, too.
And I'm sitting here thinking, what are you talking about?
I taught you this, too! Because you sent me that battle, like, right when we started talking. You sent me that battle of a Sharpedo using Blizzard, and I was just like, what the hell's going on here? What?
What?
Yeah, it didn't even have a speed boost. It had Rough Skin, which, like, you know, I don't usually argue about some abilities, but some of them really are just better. And on Sharpedo, speed boost is really just the ability to have, because Rough Skin is really only a useful ability if you can tank a hit.
Yes.
Sharpedo, that is my argument.
Yeah, Sharpedo can't take much of a hit, in my opinion.
It has, like, 60 in both defenses. Pretty sure.
So, yeah, it's not going to take a hit. So, Rough Skin, not exactly going to be the best ability. Oh, see, I won't even give Rough Skin to, like, a Garchomp.
Actually, I don't mind giving it to a Garchomp, because it can actually tank a few hits as long as it's not ice. Because some people have actually started investing HP into it because they don't want to be one-shotted by Hidden Power Ice Manectric. Oh, Mega Manectric, but...
Yeah, I actually have max HP and I believe split defenses in a current Talonflame of mine. That thing can take a Thunder from Thunderous like it's nobody's business.
Seriously?